One of the strongest Spider-Man villains versus one of the smartest Flash villains. Who do you think wins and why? Comment it down below, and while you're down there, suggest a battle if you have one. Before becoming the Rhino, Alexei was just an ordinary Russian mobster. This would quickly change when he underwent a series of gamma radiation treatments that granted him superhuman strength and speed. Alexei would also be permanently bonded to a power suit that was designed to look like a rhinoceros. After he obtained these abilities, the Rhino would betray the two scientists who created him. In his first act of villainy, the Rhino tried to kidnap John Jameson, son of J. Jonah Jameson. This plan would be stopped by Spider-Man after he and Dr. Connors, aka the Lizard, discovered how to disintegrate the Rhino suit. This wouldn't be the end of the Rhino. He would go on to fight Spider-Man and many other heroes on several different occasions. The Rhino's superhuman abilities are the result of treatments involving gamma radiation. The gamma radiation increased his cellular structure and added several hundred pounds of muscle and bone tissue. As the years have gone on, Alexis has repeated the process which originally gave him his powers. By doing this, the Rhino has increased his durability and strength by a lot. For example, the Rhino can easily destroy metal beams like they're nothing. He's durable enough to withstand punches from Spider-Man and the Hulk. That's enough about the Rhino, let's look at Gorilla Grodd for a minute. Gorilla Grodd isn't an ordinary gorilla. His mind has the power to control others and lift objects without touching them. As if this wasn't enough, Grodd is also gifted with an above average intelligence. He gained these abilities after he was exposed to a radioactive meteor. Gorilla Grodd possesses incredible amounts of strength, durability, and speed. He can easily break through walls and is capable of tossing cars like they're nothing. He's taken multiple punches from Wonder Woman and Wally West. These aren't all the abilities Grodd possesses. He's capable of telepathically controlling others and can create force field bubbles. So who wins and why? Let's analyze the Rhino and Grodd some more and compare feats to feats, but before we do, there are going to be some rules. In the first round, Grodd won't be allowed to use his telepathy nor his telekinesis. The Rhino, however, won't have any restrictions. In the second round, nothing really changes, except for the fact that Grodd now is allowed to use all of his abilities. In the third and final round, both the Rhino and Grodd will be in Bloodlust. The battle will also mainly focus on these categories. Any other notable feats or attributes will go into their X factor. With that being said, let's get started. The first category is strength. The Rhino is capable of punching Spider-Man through a concrete pillar and derailing a train. He can also easily destroy a building and lift an entire roof over his head. One of the Rhino's best strength feats was when he was able to hurt the Grey Hulk. This is impressive because Joe Fixit can be hurt by knives or bullets. Gorilla Grodd is also pretty strong. He's easily been able to punch through multiple walls and can easily throw a car through a building. One of Grodd's best strength feats was when he was able to toss a cement mixer into the air with a single hand. A cement truck can weigh anywhere from 10 to 20 tons. This is a very impressive feat. But even with this, the Rhino still takes the strength category, and it's mainly due to him not only being able to harm Joe Fixit, but Classic Hulk as well. This Hulk is capable of withstanding tank shells. When it comes to their durability, the Rhino has shown to be completely unaffected by bullets and a rocket from an RPG. He survived a truck being slammed into him and Iron Man's repulsor blast. The Rhino's best durability feat was when he was able to survive multiple punches from Classic Hulk. This is super impressive because Classic Hulk's punches are like an atomic bomb. Grodd's durability isn't bad either. He's withstood 3,000 punches from Wally West. One simple punch from West is capable of destroying a car. Grodd's best durability feat was when he was able to survive multiple punches from Wonder Woman. This is impressive because Wonder Woman's punches are capable of hurting Convict, a villain who moments before took punches from Superman which were capable of destroying small planets. It's because of this that Grodd takes the durability category. As for their speed, the Rhino has been shown to be capable of blitzing Spider-Man and outrunning a train. This is impressive, but it's nowhere near the level of his opponent. This is mainly due to Grodd being able to catch the Flash on multiple different occasions. It's mainly due to this that Grodd takes the speed category. And finally, let's look at their X factor. Unfortunately, the Rhino doesn't really have an X factor, but Gorilla Grodd does, and this is telepathy and telekinesis. With his telepathy, he can mind control others, including superpowered individuals such as Supergirl. His telepathy would be increased to the point where it was stronger than that of Martian Manhunters. Grodd's telekinesis allows him to do several different things, like restrain his opponents and create powerful force fields. When we look at everything they've been able to accomplish, who wins and why, I'm gonna give the first round to Grodd. Yes, the Rhino might have the better strength, and by a lot. However, this really isn't going to help him, seeing as Grodd does have the superior durability and speed. Emphasis on the speed. Gorilla Grodd's speed is much, much greater than that of the Rhino's. Alexei's best speed feat was when he was able to outrun a train, and Grodd's was when he was able to catch the Flash. With his more than superior speed, Grodd should easily have no trouble dodging and countering the Rhino's attacks. Even if the Rhino actually manages to hit Grodd, it really shouldn't affect him, seeing as he does have incredible amounts of durability. In the second round, Grodd will gain access to his telekinesis and telepathy. Here, it will be even easier for him to win, seeing as the Rhino doesn't possess any way to counter Grodd's telepathy. There are countless ways Gorilla Grodd could win with his telepathy alone. For example, Grodd could easily paralyze or mind control the Rhino. Grodd easily took the first two rounds, but what if both the Rhino and Grodd were in bloodlust? Would this change the outcomes of the battle, or will they remain the same? The Rhino with bloodlust is a beast. It isn't going to be easy for Grodd to win the final round, but he is. And again, it's mainly due to his more than superior speed and telepathy. Grodd with bloodlust isn't going to hesitate to use his telepathy on the Rhino, therefore giving him the win. In a quick summary, Gorilla Grodd won the first round due to his better durability and speed. Grodd won the second round due to his telepathy and telekinesis. And finally, Grodd won the last round due to his superior speed and telepathy. That's going to do it for this battle. If you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe and comment down below who you think wins this battle. With that being said, I'll see you down in the next one.